Good morning, friends. On behalf of Commissioners of Technical Education, that is from Gandhinagar, Government of Gujarat, I welcome all of you in this video lecture series. Our today's lecture subject is Applied Mechanics. The GTU code for this subject is 3300008, and our today's topic is Center of Gravity. Now, this is our third lecture. In the last two lectures, we already studied about the theory of center of gravity, what is its real life application, and the examples for two-dimensional theory, that is for the two-dimensional figure. Let's quickly recap what we already done in the last two lectures. This is the manner and guideline. In this lecture, you already know this thing, that is, be reasonable and act politely, turn off your mobile phone. If you have the urgent calls to make or answer, kindly leave the room. No food is allowed in my classroom, only water and candy are allowed. That is, in the case of any throat infection or any other problem you had. No noisy chat are allowed in my classroom, and all other activities that can distract you from the lecture should be avoided. Do not disturb your classmates and dress properly. This is our main topic, that is centroid and center of gravity, and today is our third lecture. We are going to revise the last two lectures, that is the centroid and center of gravity. What do you mean by the centroid? Centroid is a function of dimensions, that is, it is a geometric property only, where the center of gravity is the function of specific weight. In the centroid, it is a point where whole area of the figure is concerned, while in the center of gravity, it is a point where the whole mass of the solid is concerned. Why area? Because it is a two-dimensional figure where the center of gravity is used for the three-dimensional figure. So, in the center, only area is concerned, while in the center of gravity, that is mass is concerned because it is a solid figure. The main example for centroid is square, rectangle, triangle, circle, and the example for center of gravity is cube, cuboid, cone, sphere, and cylinder. Centroid is only for the areas, so we are denoted it by G, where the center of gravity is for the solid figures, we are going to denote it by the CG. We already discussed about the reference axis, that is the axis of x and y with the original. In the right side there is x, positive x, and in the left side there is a negative x, while in the upper side there is a positive y, and at the lower side there is a negative y. So from from this reference axis we make the quadrant 4, that is, in the first quadrant, that is a positive x and positive y, while positive y and negative x makes the quadrant number 2. If we consider the negative x and negative y, that is the quadrant number 3, while we are considering the negative y and positive x, that is the quadrant number 4. That means for the reference axis, we have totally 4 quadrants. And we already studied the another terminology, that is called axis of symmetry. That means a one axis which make the figure in the two part, like it is a mirror image of one part is the mirror image of the another part. That means if you stand against the mirror and it exactly looks like you, so the figure, if exactly look like the other figure, it is called the axis of symmetry. You can see the picture which we already studied. The step to find out the CG of an area, or we call the step to find out the centroid. The first step is put the whole figure in the first quadrant, because in the first quadrant x and y both are totally positive. So put the whole figure in the first quadrant in such a manner that the leftmost portion of the figure touches the y-axis and the lowermost portion of the figure touches the x-axis. Then step number 2, divide the whole figure into the known CG figure, That means we had the known CG figures. That means the rectangle, triangle, right angle triangle, circle, semicircle, ellipse. We already know this figure CG. So divide the figure into the known CG figure. Give number to the parted figure. We divide the figure into the known CG figure, then give one by one number to the divided figures. Find out the area for individual part and write it in the tabular form. So we know the CG, that means we already know the area of particular figure. So divide the figure, give its number, and then find out the area for a particular figure. Then find out the x and y coordinate for individual part with reference to the reference axis and write it in the tabular form. So we have the x and y coordinate with reference to the reference axis. Then finally use the formula, that is our step number 6. And last but not the least step is mark the CG on the figure. We have to follow this step for each and every figure which CG or centroid we want. We already discussed this example. This is the forward T section. We already studied this example in the last lecture, and we find the CG, that is the 50 and 68.33. This is the symmetrical axis example. Yeah, in this example, or you can say in this section is symmetrical about YY axis. We are directly getting the value of X bar. This is another example. It is the example of reverse T, and is in this example we get the value of Y bar different, because both the example, that is the example 1 and 2, both are the axis symmetry example. So the value of X bar remains same, but the value of Y bar, because of its position, it changing. So we can say the position matters in the CG example. This is another example of ZR section. By first look, we consider it as the axis of symmetry, but it is not actually the axis of symmetry example, because at the center, if you put a mirror, you can't find the same image in the mirror. But if you remove the mirror, so you can't find the same image. So it is not the axis of symmetry example. So you have to find both the values, that is X bar and Y bar. The another example we solve is, it is a combination of semicircle, then rectangle, then right angle triangle. So we solve this example, but this example is not the axis of symmetry example. That means it's X and Y in both the axis, the figure is not same. So we have to find the value of X bar and Y bar. Now today we are going to start the another example, that is our example number 5. So be ready with your calculator. This is the example number 5. Find the centroid of an Indian standard angle, that is called ISA, 90 by 60 by 6 mm, with longer leg vertical. You can see the figure. In the longer leg, the value is 90, the shorter leg value is 60, and thickness throughout the figure, that means for the longer leg and shorter leg, the thickness is 6 mm. So by looking in the first sight, we can find that it is a combination of two rectangles. So I divided the figure in the two parts, so you can see it. This is our reference axis, that means I put whole the figure in the quadrant number 1, that is our first step. So I put the whole figure in the quadrant number 1, then I divide it and give the number, that is the vertical has the number 1 and the horizontal rectangle has the number 2. So I put the figure in the first quadrant, then I divide it to the known CG, that is the rectangle, because I had the value of rectangle, and then I gave the number, that is the vertical rectangle has the number 1, and the horizontal rectangle has the value 2. That means our first rectangle has the value 90 minus 6, that is equal to 84 by vertical value, and horizontal value is 6, while the horizontal rectangle has the value 60 by 6. Let's see and find the area. This is our tabular form. So the area for the first figure is 84 by 6, and that's why that is the B into H, or we can say L into B. So the value is 84 into 6, so the answer is 504. The x bar value, or you can say the x1 value, is 6 divided by 2, that is equal to 3. For the y bar value, we had the 6 plus 42, that is 84 by 2, that is the answer of 42, and that is why 6 plus 42 equal to 48. So here the value of a1x1 equal to 504 into the value of x1 is 3. So the total answer is 1512, while the value of a1y1 is 504 into 48. So the answer is 24192. For the second shape, that is the horizontal rectangle, we had the area 60 into 6, that is 60 is the horizontal value, 6 is the vertical value. So the answer is 360, and the value of x bar is, total value is 60, so 60 by 2, that is equal to b by 2, so the answer is 30. And the value of y bar equal to 6 divided by 2, that is equal to 3. So we got the value of x bar, y bar, that is x2 and y2, and the area of a2. So for the second figure, that is a2x2 equal to 360 into 30, that is equal to 10800, while the value of a2y2 equal to 360 into 3, that is equal to 1080. So the total summation of area is, that is 864, while the total summation of AX bar, that is equal to A1X1 plus A2X2 equal to 12312, while the value for AY bar, that is equal to summation of A1Y1 plus A2Y2, and that is equal to 25272. Put these values in your formula, that is the x bar equal to summation of AX upon summation of AY. That means summation of AX equal to A1X1 plus A2X2. We already found this value in the last table. That means the value is 12312 divided by the total summation of area, that is A1 plus A2, that is equal to 864. So our x bar value for this angle section is 14.25 mm. Similarly, we can find the y bar value, that is equal to y bar equal to summation of AY upon summation of A. So the value is A1Y1 plus A2Y2 divided by A1 plus A2. So the answer is 25272 divided by 864. That value we took from the last table. So the answer is 29.25. So our last step is to put the CG in the figure. So I put the CG in the figure. Exactly not necessary, but approximation is necessary. So this is my G point, its coordinate are 14.25 and 29.25. Let's move on to the next example. This is the example number 6. In this example, we are finding the centroid of a given lamina as shown below. This is the lamina or plate or a 2D figure. We already discussed about the lamina, so I am not going to discuss in this lecture. In this section, we had the three parts. That means the vertical portion had the values 40 into 10. The horizontal portion has the value 60 into 10, while the again downward portion has the value 40 into 10. By looking this, we understood, yeah, we assume that it is a symmetry figure, but no, it is not a symmetry figure. Let's see quickly. Put this whole figure in the first quadrant. As I already told that putting this figure in the first quadrant in such a manner that the lowermost portion of the figure touches the x-axis while the leftmost portion touches the y-axis. See, you can see easily I put the figure in such a manner that the upper portion touches the y-axis while the lower portion touches the x-axis. Then give the numbering. The lower portion I gave number 1, the middle portion I gave number 2, and the upper portion I gave the number 3. As we already done in all the last examples, the same methodology we have to follow here. That means put the figure in the first quadrant, divided it in the known portion, give the numbering and find the areas. So this is the areas, 30 into 10. So the value is 300. The x1 coordinate is 60 plus it's 10 by 2 because it is the value of 30 by 10. So we got the answer 60 plus 5, that is equal to 65. The y1 coordinate is total height is 30. So 30 by 2, that is equal to h by 2, that is equal to 15. And the value for a1 x1 is 300 is our area, and the x1 coordinate is 65. So our answer is 19500. Similarly, for the a1 y1, the area for the a1 is equal to 300, while the y1 coordinate we found is 15. So our formula is a1 y1. By putting the values of a1 and y1, 300 into 15, we got the answer 4500. For the figure number 2, we had the horizontal rectangle, that is the value is 70 by 100. That means the total summation is 700. The x2 coordinate is 70 by 2. That is equal to 35 is the answer. Y2 coordinate is 30 plus 10 divided by 2. So that is equal to 35. That means 30 plus 5 equal to 35. The A2 x2 coordinate is 700 into 35. That is equal to 24500, while the A2Y2 answer is 700 into 35. That means the Y2 coordinate we had is 35. So 700 into 35 equal to 24500. For the figure number 3, or we can say for the third part, that is the upper part, we had the value 30 into 10. So the answer is 300. The x bar coordinate is 10 divided by 2, that is b by 2, that is 10 divided by 2 equal to 5, while the y3 coordinate is 30, the height of the lower part plus 10, that is the height of middle part, plus 30 by 2, that is the height of upper portion itself. So 30 by 2, so we got 30 plus 10, that is 40, plus 15, so answer is 55. For the A3X3, the value is 300 into 5, so the answer is 1500. And for the answer A3Y3, we had the value 300 into 55, that is 16500. So we had the total area 1300, while the total summation of A1X1 plus A2X2 plus A3X3 is 45500, while AY coordinator, that is A3Y3 equal to summation of A1Y1 plus A2Y2 plus A3Y3 equal to 45500. We can put these values in the formula. So we got the answer, that is the summation of AX upon summation of A equal to 45500 divided by 1300. So our answer is 35. While for the Y bar, summation of AY upon summation of A, that is equal to 45500 divided by 1300. So our answer is 35 mm. Put this value as a G coordinate, that is CG coordinate, and we got the position of G at the center, that is G has the 35 by 35. Let's see the another example. Example number 7. We had the another shape for this example. We already studied about the T section, Z section, reverse T, reverse Z. Now we have the C section, yeah, we can say the channel section. For this section, find the centroid of a given section as shown in figure. All dimensions are in centimeter. Here the dimensions are given in the centimeter. Before this example, all the dimensions are given in mm. So in this example, the dimensions are given in centimeter, so the dimensions value are very small compared to the mm value. Okay, because the conversion of centimeter to mm is multiplied by 10. So in this example, we can divide the figure in the three part so that we got the known figure, that is the three rectangle, two horizontal rectangle and one vertical. As we know already this thing, so put the figure in the first quadrant. So you can see I put hold the figure in the quadrant number 1 because x and y both are positive in this quadrant. This is the number 1, number 2 and number 3. The number 1 had the value, that is the dimension for number 1 is 12 into 4, that means 12 is its horizontal dimension and 4 is its vertical dimension, while for number 2 the horizontal dimension is 4 and the vertical dimension is 16, and number 3 the horizontal dimension is 12 and the horizontal dimension is 4. By seeing it, it is symmetrical about the x-axis, that means the x-axis, it is symmetrical, so we directly got the value of y bar. That means we can divide the whole height by 2 and we got the y bar value. See, as shown in the figure is symmetrical about x axis. Therefore, the y bar equal to 24 by 2. How come 24 comes? It is in this way, 16 plus 4. So, 20 plus 4. So, 24. So, the y bar value is 24 by 2 and that is equal to 12 centimeter. Again, use the same steps. That means for the first figure, find out the area, that is equal to 12 into 4, that is equal to 48. While for the x1 coordinate, we can get the value, that is 12 by 2, that is equal to 6. While the summation of A1X1, that is you can call it multiplication of A1X1, is 48 into 6 equal to 288. By second figure, we had the horizontal rectangle whose size is 16 into 4. So we got the value is 64 and the x bar value is 4 by 2 because the length equal to 4, so b by 2, so answer is 4 by 2 and that is equal to 2. The A2X2 value is 64 into 2 because A2 is 64 and X2 is 2, so 64 into 2, so the answer is 128. For the third figure, that is the area is 12 by 4, so the answer is 48 cm square, while the x bar value is 12 divided by 2 equal to 6. So the answer is 48 into 6 equal to 288. This way we can calculate the whole values. Here we can say the area and x coordinator and summation of area and x coordinator. So total area is A1 plus A2 plus A3, while the summation of A and x coordinator, that is A1 x1 plus a2 x2 and plus a3 x3. So the summation of area is 160 and the summation of a and x coordinator is 704. So put these values in the formula, that is the x bar value equal to summation of ax and summation of a x bar equal to 704 divided by 160, that is equal to 4.4. We do not need the y bar value because we already found it. So directly put the values as a g coordinator, that means CG or centroid coordinator, and that is the 4.4 x coordinator and y bar coordinator we already found, that is the 12. So this way we completed this example. That is the another example. You can see in this example, one dam is shown in this example. So, find centroid of dam section with top width 3 meter, bottom width 6 meter and height is 9 meter with one face vertical. And all dimensions are in meter. In the last example, that is the example number 7, all dimensions are in centimeter, and in example number 6, all dimensions are in mm. So you should preferably refer in which unit all the examples are given and all the data is given for a particular example, and you should follow that thing. So here is one dam and its left side there is water, and between the dam and water there is one vertical surface. And the top of dam width is 3 meter and the base is 6 meter and the height of dam is 9 meter, as you can see in the picture. So I divided this dam in the two part, that is the 3 meter by 9 meter one rectangle, and 3 meter is the base and 9 meter height of the triangle, that is the right angle triangle. So for better understanding, I remove the water portion and draw the line diagram for this dam. That is, you can see the line diagram for the dam which center of gravity we should find. So it is one rectangle and one triangle. I put this figure in the first quadrant, then give number to this. So I gave number, that is the number 1 for rectangle section, that is 3 by 9, and number 2 for the right angle triangle, that is the value for base is 3 meter, because from the 6 meter already 3 meter base taken by the rectangle and the height is for 9 meter. So we can find the area and the value for the x and y coordinator, because the dam is not symmetrical about any axis, that is x axis and y axis. So the first is the rectangle, so the area is 9 meter height and 3 meter its width, so the total area is 27 meter square, while for the x value, that is the height is the width is 3 meter, so 3 by 2, that is equal to 1.5, while for the y bar, the answer is 9 divided by 2, that is equal to 4.5. So the value of A1 X1 is the multiplication of area, that is 27 meters square, and the multiplication of X1 value, that is equal to 1.5. So the answer is 40.5. And for the y coordinator, that is the area equal to 27 into the y1 value is 4.5. So the answer is 121.5. For the another shape, that is the right angle triangle, we had the area, that is 1/2 BH, that means 1/2 into base into the height. So the 3 is the base, 9 is the height, and divide by 2. So the answer is 13.5 meters square. For the x1 coordinator, the value is 3 meter width of rectangle plus the total area, total x coordinator of right angle is h by 3 and b by 3. So the b by 3 value is 3 by 3. So our answer is 3 plus 1, that is equal to 4. While for the y coordinator, the answer is h by 3 directly, because it is not connected with any other object height wise. So the answer is 9 by 3. So that is equal to 3. So the A2X2 value, that is equal to 13.5 into the 4 is the X2 value. So we got the answer is 54. While A into Y bar, that is equal to A2Y2 value. For that thing, 13.5 into the Y2 answer is 3. So we got the answer 40.5. So summation, that is A1 X1. That is equal to 27 plus 13.5. So we got the answer 40.5. While for the A1 X1 plus A2 X2, the answer is 40.5 plus 54. So answer is 94.5. And A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2. So 121.5 plus 40.5. We got the answer 162. Put these values in the formula. So our answer is summation of AX upon summation of A, that is equal to 94.5 divided by 40.5. So we got the X coordinator for our dam is 2.33, and the Y coordinator is summation of AY and summation of A, that is equal to 162 upon 40.5. So our answer is 4 meter. So the CG for a particular dam is G, we donated here, and the answer is 2.33 is the X coordinator and 4 is the Y coordinator. So the CG point falls in the rectangular portion. I show this thing in my picture. You can see easily this thing. Okay, let's move over to the next example. That is the example number 9. This is the example. Till this example, the figures are jointed with the horizontally, and in this example, the figure is jointed vertically. So there is a slight difference between these two by finding the area and CG. So for example number 9, determine the CG of a given section as shown in below figure. All dimensions are in centimeter. So in the last dam example, we had the dimensions in meter, but in this example, we had the dimensions in centimeter. Here is one plate and one triangle. So I divided the portion in the two parts, you can see, with a pink portion and with the green portion. Pink portion is a rectangle, while the mandi or green portion is a right angle triangle. So I put the figure in the first quadrant, then I divide the figure as a known figure and I give number to them, that is number 1 to the rectangle and number 2 to the triangle. So I had the dimensions of rectangle is 12 is the horizontal dimension, while 3 is a vertical dimension. And for the base of triangle, the total size is 12, the total size minus the 3, So the total size for the base for the triangle is 12 minus 3 equal to 9, while the height for triangle is also 12 minus 3, that is equal to 9. So we had the dimension for triangle is 9 height and 9 base, while the dimension for rectangle is 12 base and 3 height. Let's count its area. So for a first, our shape is rectangle, and so the area is 12 by 3. So we had the answer 36 cm square. While for the x1 coordinate, we had the value that is b by 2, that is equal to 6. While for the y1 coordinate, we had the value h by 2, that is equal to 3 by 2, and that is equal to 1.5. So a1 x1 coordinate is 36 is our a1 coordinate, while 6 is the x1 coordinate. So the answer is 36 into 6 equal to 216. While the a1 y1 coordinate, 36 into 1.5, so the value is 54. For the second figure, that is the right angle triangle, the area is same formula, that is 1/2 bh, b is a base and h is the height. So we can say that 9 into 9 divided by 2, so the area for the second figure is 40.5 centimeter square. The x2 coordinate is b by 3, that is equal to 9 by 3, so the answer is 3. While the y coordinate is h by 3, but it is the value counted from the reference axis. So our y2 coordinate is 3 plus 9 by 3, so the answer is 6. So we got this way the x2 and y2 coordinate and the a2 value. So the multiplication of a2 and x2 is 40.5 into 3, so we got the answer is 121.5. While the a2 and y2 value is 40.5 into 6, so the answer is 243. It means if we had the summation of area ax and ay coordinate, we got the answer by a1 plus a2 equal to 36 cm square plus 40.5 cm square. So the total summation of area is 76.5 cm square. While for AX coordinate, A1 X1 value is 216, while the A2 X2 value is 121.5. So the answer is 337.5. While for the A1 Y1, the answer is 54, that means our AY coordinate for the first figure is 54, and for the second figure, AY coordinate, that is A2 into Y2, is 243. We got the summation A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 is a 54 plus 243 is 297. So we can put these values in our equation and got the value of CG. You can see the x bar value is summation of ax into the summation of area, that is the 337.5 upon 76.5, and y bar value is summation of ay, that is a1 y1 plus a2 y2 divided by a1 plus a2. So we got the answer, that is 297 divided by 76.5. So our x coordinate is 4.41 centimeter, while our y coordinate is 3.88 centimeter. So in this way, we got the answer for x and y coordinate. That means the g coordinate is, that is our point of centroid, or we can say the CG point. So its coordinate is 4.41 centimeter, and y coordinate is 3.88 centimeter. So you can solve all the examples in this manner. Shape doesn't matter, but position matters. So you can solve all the examples in this manner, and the same steps are required for these examples, you can follow the same steps and you can solve any shape, any examples. Let's move on to the next example. That is example number 10. In the example number 10, we are calculating the CG of given section as shown in below figure. Here all dimensions are in mm. Here there is a one rectangle, and on this rectangle there is a one semicircle, and besides this rectangle there is a triangle, and in between this rectangle and triangle there is one hole which is circular. So the diameter for this hole is 24, so we can say the radius for this hole is 12. The semicircle has the radius 30. The height of rectangle section is 90, and the total base is 120. It is the combination of rectangle and triangle base, then that is the value is 120. The height is 30. That means the center of the hole is 30 mm above the baseline. So we have to follow the same steps. First, we should keep the whole figure in the reference axis, in between the reference axis, or we can say put the whole figure in the first quadrant. So I put the whole figure in the first quadrant. Then divide the figure in the known CG figure. So I divided it into the four part. The first part is rectangle. Second part is semicircle. The third part is triangle, that is right angle triangle. And fourth part is a circle. So the dimension for a rectangle is 90 mm height, while the width is it is same as the radius of the semicircle, because semicircle is exactly put on it. So the radius of semicircle is 30 mm. So the diameter of semicircle is 60 mm. So the base of rectangle is also 60 mm. Now the dimension for the right angle triangle is, the total length is 120 mm. And the base of rectangle is 60 mm. So the base of triangle is also 60 mm. And the height of triangle is 90 mm. So we can say the dimension of semicircle is radius 30. Rectangle is 90 by 60. And for the right angle triangle, the dimension is base is 60 and height is 90. The dimension for circle is radius equal to 12, and so the center, the circle is above the 30 mm height, and it is at the center of 30 mm. So the height of the circle is 30 minus 12, its radius. So we got the answer is 18. So put these values in our tabular format and find the area, x coordinator and y coordinator, and then we can got the value of our CG. This is our tabular format. So the first figure is rectangle. So the area is 60 base and 90 height. So B into H, that is equal to 60 into 90. So the value is 5400. While the x coordinate is 60 divided by 2, that is b by 2, a standard formula, and that's why we got the value 60 divided by 2 equal to 30. The y formula is height by 2, so the answer is 90 divided by 2, so the answer is 45. That is h by 2, so we got the answer 90 divided by 2 equal to 45. The A1 X1 coordinator is 5400 is our A1 coordinator, and the X1 coordinator is 30. So multiplication of this 2 is 5400 into 30, that is equal to 162000. While the AY coordinator is A1, Y1, and the answer is 5400 multiplied by with the Y coordinate, that is 45. So we got the multiplication answer 243000. Again, that is for the second step, or we can say the second shape. We had the area, that is pi r square by 2. See, the total area of a circle is pi r square or pi by 4 d square. So here we are using the r square, so pi r square. So for the semicircle, semicircle means half the circle. So the area is pi r square divided by 2. So the answer is pi into 30 square divided by 2. We got the answer 1413.71. While the x bar, that is x2 value equal to, and that is equal to the value of radius, and that is equal to 30. The value of y bar is, that is equal to 90 plus 4r upon 3 pi, that is equal to 102.73. Now you had the problem. In the last time we say that the x1 value is r. But in this example, I said that the x2 value is r, but the y2 value had the 4r upon 3 pi value. So how it comes? So let's see this thing in our tally top so that you can understand it very easily. See it. Here is the value of x and y. I had the y coordinate, I had the x coordinate. And this is my semicircle. So I got this value. This is r, and this is the 4r upon 3 pi. And so this is the value of r. So I got this answer as r minus 4r upon 3 pi, because this is the value of r, and this is the value of 4r upon 3 pi. So this is the value of r minus 4r upon 3 pi. Got it? If I put it in this manner, on my x and y axis, so I got the x coordinate as r, but y coordinate is 4r upon 3 pi. But if I put it in this manner, that is regarding the y axis, so my x coordinate is 4r upon 3 pi, while my y coordinate is r. If I put this again in this manner, suppose, so my x value is again r, but my y value is r minus 4r upon 3 pi, because we found this value always with the reference axis. If position changes, my values will be changed. If I put it in this manner, so the answer is my x value is r minus 4r upon 3 pi. And again, my y value is r. Okay, got it? Should I repeat it? Okay, I repeat. If I put my semicircle on the x-axis, this is my y-axis, this is my x-axis. If I put my semicircle in this manner, so my x-coordinate is r. You can see it and check it easily. But my y-coordinate is 4r upon 3 pi. But if I put this semicircle in this manner, directly opposite to the first one, so my y coordinate, x coordinate remains same, but the y coordinate will be changed. That means my y coordinate is r minus 4r upon 3 pi, because we have to take the values with on the reference axis base. So from the reference axis, if position changes, the value of x coordinate and y coordinate will be changed. Similarly, if I put my semicircle on the y basis, so the value of y for this thing is r, but the value of x is changing. So this is 4r upon 3 pi. But if I put it in the opposite direction, so So my value of x again changing, that means my value of x is r minus r minus 4r upon 3 pi. Got it? So move to our example. Our area is pi r square by 3, that is equal to 1413.71. My x coordinate, as we see earlier on tally top, that is the value of r, so 30. And my y coordinate is 90 plus 4 into 30 divided by 3 pi. So the answer is 102.73. My a1 x1 value is 5400 into 30, that is equal to 162,000. And my a1 A2x2 value is 1413.71 into 30, that is equal to 42408. My AY value is 1413.71 into 102.73, that is equal to 145219.2. So the summation of area is, we had the another values, that is the triangle. So the area is 60 into 90 by 2, that is equal to 1 half BH. So the answer is 2700, while my x1 and y1 coordinate is 60 plus 60 by 3, that is equal to 80. While my y coordinate is, that is the h by 3, that is equal to 30. So area into x coordinate is 2700 into 80, that is equal to 216,000, and the area and y coordinate is 2700 into 30, that is equal to 81000. Now we had the hole, that is the circular, so the area is pi r square, that is equal to pi into 12 square, so the area is 452.40, while the x coordinate is 60 plus 12, that is 12, because the radius for circular section is 12 and the answer is 72. For the y coordinate, the answer is 30 plus 12, that is equal to 42. So our x1 y1 coordinate is x coordinate and to area equal to 452.4 into 72, that is equal to 32573. While the area into y coordinate is 452.4 into 42 equal to 19000.8. So the total summation of area is 9061.2. It is how it comes. It is A1 plus A2 plus A3 minus A4. A4 area should be deducted because it is a whole. It is not participating in the CG. And the total summation of area into x coordinate, that is a1 x1 plus a2 x2 plus a3 x3 minus a4 x4. As I told you, the whole is not considered in the total summation, so it should be deducted, and the answer is 3878.35. while the summation of a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 minus a4 y4, that is equal to 450218.4. The formula used for this thing is this. The summation is 38783.5 divided by the area 9061.2, that is equal to 42.80, while for the y coordinator 450218.4, and the answer divided by this thing area equal to 9061.4. So we got the x coordinate 42.80, while the y coordinate 49.7 centimeter. Put this value in the g, and this is the g coordinate. So we finally got the answer, that is the center of gravity for this thing. So in today's lecture, we solved the example with combination of different figures and with the whole. So we continue with this thing in the next lecture. Thank you.